everyone. In our today's video, we shall learn about social studies of 10th standard. Okay, here we have 21 lessons, 21 units in total, where 1 to 11 lessons will be in paper 1 and 12 to 21 will be in paper 2. Okay, paper 1 will be normally based on the geography and also a little bit economics part. Okay, and paper 2 is based on civics and also history. Okay, so in our first paper, our first topic is India Relief Features. Okay, India, we all live in India, right? And we know like India is a vast country with different kinds of landforms. Okay, what are they, like different types of landform, how it is formed, which is the location of the India. This will find it in the first lesson, and in the remaining lessons we will be learning about the rivers, the population, the economy, globalization, like different, we will be learning about different factors of India, even the temperature, the climate, everything we'll be learning in the further classes. Okay, first thing, there are six major reliefs of relief features of India. They are the Himalayas, Indo-Gangetic Plains, the Peninsula Plateau, the coastal plains, the desert and the islands. These are the six major relief features of India. Before going to learn about these six major relief features, we shall just go into the basics. Okay, as we know, this is our globe, right? Okay, in the globe, we can find across latitudes and longitudes. What are latitudes? Latitudes are the horizontal lines and longitudes are the vertical lines. Why do we use this? These are just imaginary lines. Why do we use these lines? We use these lines to know the exact location of a place, to get any place. If we take in mathematics, we come across different points like 1.2, 2.2 to make a point. In the same way here also, this point here, based on the latitude and the longitude, we can mark, we can locate something, locate the place very easily. So, these latitudes and longitudes are the imaginary lines which will be helpful to find out the location. Okay, now let's learn deeply about latitudes. Okay, latitudes are known as parallels. Like, these are the latitudes. They are parallels. They are also called as parallels. And they run from east-west direction. As I said, like east-west. East and west, they are horizontal lines. Okay, measure the distance north or south from the equator. Now, this is very important. The dotted line which you are seeing here on the globe is the equator, which is 0 degree latitude, which is at 0 degree latitude. Now, this equator is at 0 degree and the upper portion is the north one and the lower portion is called as the south one. Okay, and these two portions are called as northern hemisphere and this is the southern hemisphere. Okay, normally any circle, if we divide into two, it is called as hemispheres, right? Okay, so this is the northern hemisphere and this is the southern hemisphere. Okay, whenever you can see here, this is the biggest, equator is the longest, biggest latitude on the globe. So, whenever it goes towards the poles, these are the poles. These are the poles. Okay, whenever the equator is going towards, like the lines are going towards the pole, the size of the latitude decreases. Even towards the north side, even towards the south side, the length of the latitude decreases. And this one, equator is the biggest latitude, as I have already said you. Okay, now longitudes. The vertical lines are called as the longitudes. Longitudes are called as meridians. Okay, this one. These are meridians. Okay, running north-south direction from north to south. Okay, latitudes will be moving from east to west. Okay, and the longitudes will be from north to east. Measures distance east or west of the prime meridian. Okay, here as 0 degree latitude is called as equator. 0 degree longitude is called as prime meridian. Okay, here, this one, 0 degree longitude is called as meridians. There are total 360 degrees longitudes, and there are 180 latitudes, 360 longitudes and 180 latitudes. Here, each 90 latitudes in the northern hemisphere and 90 latitudes in the southern hemisphere. Okay, so there are 180 latitudes on the globe and there are 360 longitudes on the globe, which runs from north to south. And 0 degree latitude is called as equator and 0 degree longitude is called as a prime meridian. And we measure east or west. Okay, here based on this we measure, like if something is on the right side of the prime meridian, then we call it as east. Okay, east longitude. If something is on left to the longitude, we call it as a west longitude. Cross equator at right angles. So these longitudes we can see here. Okay, they are perpendicular. They form right angles. When some two lines are perpendicular to each other, it forms right angles. So here these longitudes passes the equator, making right angles equal in length. Now, as we have seen in latitudes, they will decrease their length when going towards the poles. But longitudes will not decrease. They will be having the same length throughout the globe. There are 360 longitudes and 180 latitudes. Okay, this is all about the what latitudes and longitudes, and also equator and prime meridian. Now, let us it's your work to find out the location of India and Telangana. Okay, now we shall learn about this later again. Now let's move into the relief features first. Just a basic idea, basic concepts of this. Himalayas, we know that the Himalayas are the snowy mountains which are lying in India, which are the very important factors for our climate change. Okay. Indo-Gangetic plains, the plains which are formed, it's a combination of different rivers. Okay, then Peninsula Plateau, main important thing, this you have already learned, this will be learning however in this chapter, but Peninsula Plateau you might have already learned. What is a Peninsula Plateau? Any landmass where, okay, we know that this total part is covered with water, isn't it? And we have different, like here, Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea, Indian Ocean. This all lies in the southern part, like almost southern part of the India. Okay, here this side and this side and this side, that is the east side, west side and the south side, lies in the water. Okay, it is in the water. As any landmass which covers water with three of the sides is called as a peninsula plateau. And you know, most important thing is India lies in the southern hemisphere. It lies here below the equator line. It lies in the southern hemisphere. Okay, so India is called as a peninsula plateau because three sides of India landmass is covered with water. That is the reason it is called as a peninsula plateau. Okay, if any land is covered with three sides of water, then it is called as a peninsula plateau. But in case if a land is totally covered, it is surrounded along with the water, then that is called as the, it is called as an island. Okay, we know about Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Lakshadweep, all these islands. That means a piece of land where the water is surrounded on all the sides. That is called as an island. Desert, you know, where it will be very hot and there will be very least rainfall. Okay. And coastal plains, you know, like the part where the land where there is where it is a coastal side of any the coastal place is called as the coastal plains, like coastal side where the water will be like the seashores or something is called as a coastal plains. We will be learning about these in very detail in the next classes. Thank you.